Good afternoon, all the organizers and the experts of organizers sector. Private organizers, those who give me a chance to speak, I am going to talk about the rural widows who are silent victims of rural widows of our society.
Rajesh, still we are not able to hear in a proper way. Can you be a bit louder? Jury member, can you confirm if the voice is coming properly to you? Because at my end, it's not coming properly.
Yeah, it's not audible.
Rajiv, please be louder.
I'm trying my best. Good afternoon. Now you are listening. Good afternoon to all. Good afternoon to all.
Yes, yes, please go ahead.
Okay, sir. All good afternoon to all the organizers and experts of forensic psychology. Those give me a chance to speak. I am going to talk about the rural widows who are silent victims of our society. This group of population is affected by the sin of omission as a species omission from the record of many developing countries. Government policies up to uplift such vulnerable population, not only in India, but world common people are sensitized about the suffering of widows. 23rd June is marked as International Widows Day, which is an important day towards eliminating discrimination and promoting the protection of their rights. Sorry, sir, I am using my phone to seeing the slides.
Rajiv, I just want to inform you, but that your voice is not audible. I request chairperson and jury members. I think the voice is not audible. I mean, we are not getting voice from his side.
Yes, we can't hear.
Rajiv, can you please just reconnect so that, because I think there is a network glitch from your end and we are not able to listen to your voice.
I'm sorry to say, all of you are listening to me.
Rajiv, yes, now your voice is audible, so you can start just a bit louder.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Rajiv, I'm so sorry to inform that your voice is not audible.
Yes, ma'am, I am not speaking to now.
Okay. So you please okay. Start because
Sorry, ma'am. This group of population is highly affected by the sin of omission, as widows are conspicuously missing from the report of many developing countries. Government policies to uplift such vulnerable population, not only in India, all over the world. Common people are sensitized about the suffering of widows. 23rd June is marked as International Days for Widows, which is an important global step towards eliminating discrimination and promoting and protection of their rights. Our tools. Please, next slide, please. Next slide, please. Okay, post-traumatic growth. The Farage post-traumatic growth was commenced by Tedeschi and Colon in 1995, who focused upon the favorable outcomes of traumatic and negative events. Colon and Tedeschi in 1991 and 2000 define it as positive psychological change experienced as a result of the struggle with highly challenging life circumstances. To be brief, post-traumatic growth may be explained as not only going back to its touchstone, rather flourishing to some areas of life where he or she surprised or goes beyond the previous status quo. It consists of both quantitative as well as qualitative changes. Resilience, it is a psychological capacity which acts positive adaptation during adversity. Resilience leads to relatively stable, healthy levels of biopsychological functioning. It refers to the strength of an individual who serves as coping sources. This viewpoint emphasizes that after a short period of time since suffering, the person bounces back to the earlier normal functioning. According to the Panel in 2004, objectives of our study is next, please. Objectives to assess readiness and post-traumatic growth overall and its various domains among rural victims, to define how the relationship between readiness and post-traumatic growth among rural victims. Methodology. Design a correlation design was used. Sample, a purposive sample of 300 widows within the age range of 30 to 50 years. 30 to 50 years was drawn from the rural areas of Haryana and Punjab states, India. Next slide, please. For tools. Tools, resilience case, Vignan and Young, 1993. In the present study, Hindi version of this case by Rani and Nida, 2013 was used. It has 15 items to be respond to a 7-point Likert scale from 1 to 7, strongly disagree to strongly agree, respectively. The range of scores is 1 to 50 to 175. Post-traumatic growth inventory by Tedeschi and Cullen, 1996. Hindi version of inventory was used in the current research work. It consists of 21 items to be responded of 6-point Likert scale raising from 0 to 5. Pravakalpa scores in the version was shown to be 0.8 or 0.8. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. I want to discuss the results on the basis of the descriptive statistics.
Well, Rajiv, I'm on the table 1 slide, which is
okay,
showing
ma'am.
Results. Yeah. So,
okay, ma'am.
Do you want me to move to the next slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Low level of readiness may be due to lack of protective factors.
What will be helpful would be that if Rajiv can give you know, in his own words, if he can explain us the study in
yes.
short. I think that will be helpful rather than we go slide by slide in the interest of time.
Okay.
Rajiv, ma'am is saying just conclude in your words and I'll try my best to match with your movement of slide. Meanwhile, you just conclude with your words and summarize your presentation as soon as possible. Thank you.
Okay, ma'am, please go to next implication of the current studies, please. Okay, ma'am, next. implications, sorry, look, you can see the results of the low levels of readiness may due to the 10 positive factors, protective act, lack of knowledge, lack of possibilities, society is not accepted them. So that is why they are not able to accept. It is the based, our study is based on the Rosa Kubra test. See, she gives a model in 1969. So that is why she gives five aspects on which a person who faced the trauma and he, after this, the first is anger, and that he, after this he goes to the bargaining, and after this he comes to after this bargaining, and so there are five stages of the terms that after the, this a person is conclude himself and go to the stand sentences for herself. Hello.
Rajiv, now I request you to please conclude in within 1 minute, because we have extended a lot of time and we have to continue with further program of the session. So please complete in maximum in 1 minute. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. The implications are now saying experience of the death of loved ones leads to personal growth of the term of life. Gain is experienced after loss and trip of tears. Current findings would be helpful in changing the mindset of the society. Focus on the dark side of the life of widows. It may be its benefits findings helpful in counseling process. Our study is based on basically on counseling process, because all of our society is seeing on the dark side of the life of the widows, because they have their empathy, their sympathy towards them, but don't know how they are living, how they were benefit of their life, how they were believed. So said that is why we have empirical data how we can counsel the our widows, because I have a personal experience. My younger sister-in-law, my babi, also in, she is also younger in my younger to me. She also 1 year younger to me. She my brother is dead in a road accident. So that is why I take this data and choose this study. So that is why how they uplift their lives, because how can they live their lives? How can they uplift their lives? What is the stance they use to uplift their lives? So this is the main purpose of our study. I want to, because interventions are not based on this. So I want to say to the psychologists, to the counselors, how to, based on this the study, counsel them, they can uplift their lives. They have their hope, they can live, they can change their lives after the death of loved ones who may be as banned, who may be anyone. Thank you.